It's me, Bailey. Bailey Sarian. Name dropping. One of you had asked me to say my last name because you didn't know how to say it. It's Sarian. Armenian. What's up? I wanted to make a tutorial on this look right here. It's just something colorful and different than what I normally do. I hope that you like this tutorial. And I kind of start off chit-chatting a lot and then it dies off. So, sorry about that. Thank you for watching and let's get to the tutorial. So a lot's been going on. I'm currently redoing my room, like, and I didn't want to make a video while my room was still a mess. But I was like, F it. Like, I went to Paris with Makeup Forever. It was amazing. For 3 days, amazing. I brought my boyfriend with me and we had dinner at the Eiffel Tower and he proposed to me and I did not see that coming at all. Well, I kind of knew. I had that feeling, just like, Yeah, so I will kind of talk and tell stories while we go so I'm not just sitting here rambling, or I can make a separate video. Should I make a separate video? I already prepped my skin with some skincare and whatnot using the Pixi Skin Treats Glow Tonic Exfoliating Toner, 5% glycolic acid. I've been using this for a little bit now because everybody was ranting and raving about it, and so I was like, I'll try it. I haven't noticed a huge difference in my skin since using this, but I've only used it a handful of times. So give me a while and I will touch base on this again. But I washed my face, I used this. And then I used the Tatcha Balanced Pore Perfecting Water Gel Moisturizer. This is a really lightweight moisturizer. It almost feels like a water. It dries completely matte. It gives a deep hydration to the skin. It has wild rose in it, which helps diminish the size of pores over time. And then it has 23 karat gold to provide an instant glow. I didn't even know it had gold in it. Okay. I've been using this for a few days now. So again, same with like the Glow Tonic. I can't really give an honest review on it as far as help reduce the size of pores, but I will say that it's a really nice moisturizer, like a drink of water to the skin that gives a deep hydration without feeling greasy or oily. So it's great for like right now, it's 80s, 90s, it's supposed to be 100 this weekend. I need moisture, but I don't want that heavy, greasy feeling. So this one is nice. And yeah, so this, that. And it smells great. Anything from Tatcha, I feel like, has been good. When I worked at Sephora, I used to just take samples of everything. I'm a sample queen. What can I say? Okay, let's get to the foundation. So I'm going to actually use Dior Glow Maximizer Light Boosting Primer. So really funny story, I got this. It's probably honestly expired. I got it a long time ago in gratis when I worked at Sephora and I lost it. And when I was cleaning my room, I found it. And I was like, oh, this stuff is good. It has light reflectors in it. It's a champagne tone. And you can use it as a primer to give you a really pretty glow. But it's not too glittery, frosty, to where it enhances fine lines and wrinkles. It's like just right. I'm just going to use a brush. You could use your fingers, but I want to use a brush because I don't know if I know. T-zone, cheek, chin. You can also mix it in with your foundation, which I did yesterday, and it was really pretty. Makeup Forever HD Foundation, 118 is the color. I'm going to use this brush by Ayava, A-Y-V-A is how it's spelled. I actually really like this for applying liquid foundation because it gives a full coverage quickly. All the different bristles on it, grabs on, picks up the product, and puts it back on beautifully. I don't know what kind of hairs these are though. I'm kind of curious. I'll have to look it up just for my own reasoning. Okay, so I went to Paris last week with Makeup Forever. Now, Makeup Forever had contacted me a couple weeks prior and asked if I wanted to go to Paris. Like, that was the email. Do you want to go to Paris? And I was so confused because, for one, I was like, why me? And two, I was like, well, most of the time, you know, if you follow a lot of beauty people on Instagram, it's always the people or the YouTubers or Instagrammers who have more than a million subscribers or followers. Like, I asked the girl, like, are you lost? You do know I don't have that many subscribers, right? So yeah, we went back and forth for a while and it was like, for sure. And of course I couldn't say no, and everything kind of worked out perfectly because that whole week Paris trip was scheduled. I didn't have anything going on. Like, it was a really slow week for me. The only downside is that I didn't have a passport. Like, I had such issues with my passport. I don't even want to get into that mess. But So I didn't want to say anything because I was like, I don't want to jinx myself and I end up not being able to go. So I didn't say anything to anyone. Just kind of like kept it a secret. Yeah, and then I invited my boyfriend along, of course. Paris is amazing. It's gorgeous there. There's so much to see. There's so many museums. There's so much art. Like if you're just an artist in general, it's so inspiring. And for me, I've been in such like a rut. It was just amazing. Like I came back and I just was super inspired to get back into painting and drawing, which is what I really love to do. Before I continue with my story, I am now going to use the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer, NC15, and just apply with my sponge applicator under my eyes and whatnot. So when I was out in Paris, I got to meet Danny Sands, the creator of Makeup Forever, and it was just amazing. I mean, I don't want to sound like I'm bragging at all, because that's not by any means what I'm trying to do, but it just got me, like, re-inspired, the whole thing. I know I said that a bajillion times, but I got re-inspired, and I just found a new love for Makeup Forever. I've always loved Makeup Forever, the brand. I tried to work for them a few years back, and I did not get hired. They did not hire my ass. So meeting her and hearing her story was just amazing. Got to see the very first Makeup Forever boutique, and it's so cute. Paris just has so much personality. We don't have that out here. I thought LA had a lot of personality. Sure don't. So yeah, we got to walk around and just see all the sights, be a tourist. We went to dinner at the Eiffel Tower, and that's where the man proposed. I ugly cried. And then I was just like in shock, and I just didn't even know what to think. I mean, he definitely wins. That's something you read out of a romance novel. On the Eiffel Tower at night when the sun is setting, like, you win. Everybody though now keeps asking me, when are we going to get married? Like, when's the date and all that? And I'm like, I can't even think about that. I think it's gonna be like a 5-year or 10-year engagement. No rush. Is that okay? Am I allowed to do that? I'm going to use the Cover FX setting powder in light to set my concealer and whatnot. The Cover FX powder is really nice. It does have a luminosity to it. Not a glitter, just like a iridescent, I guess, finite, like a glow to it. So you want to be careful when you, like, if you set your under eye and whatnot, not to grab too much and to do your baking and all that, because it will leave a gray hue. The light reflectors can give a gray finish, if that makes any sense. Okay, now I'm going to do my eyebrows. So I'm using the Hourglass Arch Brow Sculpting Pencil in Warm Brunette. This is a retractable pencil. This brow I accidentally overplucked way too much. So I've been kind of trying to let my brows grow out. So right now they are in not the best shape. Just don't leave me alone with tweezers for too long, because it's just all bad. It's always bad. I hate doing my eyebrows. Now I'm going to contour using Makeup Geek. Boop-a-doo-doo. I'm gonna use this one. This one is called Bad Habit. I'm using an angled brush and doing a little bit of a contour. As far as blush goes and whatnot, I don't know yet. I'm gonna do my eyes and then I'll go back and decide on blush. So now I'm going to prime my eyes using the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion. I've had this bad boy forever. Still going strong. So in my last video, if you watched it, you would know, I was doing a giveaway with the Makeup Forever eyeliners and whatnot. And I figured I would do a look using those, show you what you can do with them. So I have a few colors here. I'm just gonna use like a fluffier brush with a little bit of the powder, my face powder. Put that all over the lid. It'll prevent the shadows or liners from sticking and getting muddy. Okay, so I'm going to take the Makeup Forever Aqua XL liner in D62. It's a brown with like a little bit of shimmer, I think. And I'm going to put this across my crease. I And before that dries, I'm just going to take a small blending brush or a crease brush and just smooth and soften it. Blend it out a bit. Same on the other eye. Across my crease. Blend it out. This is a Makeup Forever brush. It's the 216 brush. It's great for like the crease or smudging. I guess I am being a little brand biased. Is that the word? But we could just call this a brand focus video. Sorry, not sorry. Now I'm going to take the Aqua XL eyeliner in M92. It's a really pretty lavender color. And I'm just going to do thick line on the lash line. And then I'm going to bring it onto my bottom waterline and lash line as well. Now taking the Mega Forever Aqua XL, I don't have to tell you each time, do I? I don't know. M30, which is this pretty mint color. So I'm going right on top of the purple, like stacked on top of it, not over it. I need the mirror closer to me. Using a smudge brush, I'm just pulling out the liner a little bit to wing it. And you want to layer until you get a nice like opaque color. So I'm going to go back with the purple, just right in here. Wiping off my smudge brush and then same thing, pulling it out a bit. Just gonna finish this eye before moving on to this eye because it's, I don't really know what I'm doing. I'm just kind of like layering and seeing like what shape I like. I feel like that's how I approach all of my tutorials because I never go in with a plan and I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing. But I'm taking the liner and now going underneath the hail that I did of the purple onto my bottom lash line underneath the purple and then stopping like halfway over. I think that looks cool. And then smudging. So I'm taking the blue, it's a light blue color, and I'm just going from my tear duct halfway over, meeting up with that mint color. And then right in my upper tear duct, coming just up into my crease a little bit, just so it has like a little bit of a fade. You guys always say you want more colorful looks. Here you go. Color for you. Okay, let me do the other eye now. Anyways, these eyeliners are super waterproof and I just kind of I layer to really get the color, which means it's going to be a pain to get off because they are so waterproof. I need mascara. I'm gonna do some mascara, top and bottom lashes, and then some false lashes, and we probably won't look as crazy once we put the lashes on. I'm going to take a little bit of the Stila Custom Color Blush in Coral. And just ever so lightly. Oh, I didn't even tell you what lashes I put on. I put on Shatea Beauty lashes, and they are called Sydney. These are my favorite ones by her. So I put those on, and now I'm putting on the blush just on the apple of my cheek. For lips, I'm gonna do just like a nude pink lip. So I'm using the NYX Lip Liner in Earth Tone. This one's actually kind of dark, I forgot. And then taking Velvet 59 by Paris Manning liquid lipstick in Vanilla Macaroon. They make that label on the bottom so small. And we're done. Yeah. That took me forever. It always takes me forever. I don't know why I'm surprised. So I hope that you like this look and it inspires you to do some eye looks with just eyeliners, because it's possible and it's easy. And honestly, with summer and how sweaty and hot I get, maybe you get sweaty and hot. The eyeliners are so waterproof that, you know, they'll stay put really, really well instead of shadows. So just a look that you can do using eyeliners. If you haven't seen my last video where I am doing a giveaway, maybe you want to go see that one. If you're wondering, it is international. I didn't mention that. I will announce the winner next video. Yes, so I hope that you like this look and I hope that you give it a try. It's just makeup, it washes off. Don't freak out. Please don't leave comments saying that my brows are too big, I overdraw my lips too much, I should blend more, blah, blah, blah. Because at the end of the day, I like it, and that's all that really matters. I'm just here to share with you guys, maybe inspire you to try something a little different. Please stop leaving me comments that you wouldn't say to me in person. Stop taking life so seriously. All right, thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a really good day today, and you make great choices. Bye, guys.